The Red Cross has sounded the alarm. They're experiencing the worst blood shortage in over a decade, and they need your help. If you can give blood, please do so. We have the sign up here on our website. Check it out to come down if you're available. If not, come by and support local performers and see how you can get involved for the next event that's happening at June 3rd. Janice, thank you so much for being willing to perform at the upcoming event. It's very...
My pleasure, Rachel. It's an honor to do so. And you've asked me to pick out some of my favorite songs. So as an opera singer, I don't usually get to sing the beautiful standard jazz pieces of love songs and musical theater. So I have at least a dozen pieces that I'm ready to sing on the 15th.
And we're very excited to hear you perform. You know, we thought it'd be wonderful to have you as a way to thank the donors for coming out, especially at this critical time. There's a lot going on between fears of COVID, and hospitals are really struggling to meet the demands of their patients. So getting the attendance out is very important. So we thought having you would be a way to say thank you for making that extra effort.
My pleasure. It's an honor.
So can you tell us a little bit about who you are, what you've done, where you've traveled, and what type of music you sing?
Sure. Well, I really believe I was born to sing because God gave me this voice that was my responsibility to nurture and learn about good vocal technique, and it has led me mainly to the opera stage. Mm-hmm. I've sung in operas all over the world, a lot in New York, in Arizona, in Prague, in Copenhagen, and I love singing opera. I have a dramatic mezzo-soprano voice. But I also love to sing these beautiful songs, these standard love songs, If I Loved You and Falling in Love with Love. And it's just a really good opportunity for me to be able to sing something a little bit out of my comfort zone.
Sure, and I'm sure that some of the pieces you sing, members of the audience will probably want to sing along with you because they've probably heard them many times.
That's fine.
We encourage that if you feel so moved to sing. But do you have a favorite piece or a favorite artist that you like to sing? Or
you mean a classical artist or a non-classical artist?
We'll say non-classical artist.
Well, I love jazz. I've tried singing jazz. I wasn't very good at it, but... one of the female jazz vocalists, nobody doesn't love Ella Fitzgerald. Mm. She is at the top. Her technique, her diction, her soul. There are many, almost too many to mention. But I do love the female jazz artists, especially of the past.
Yeah, Peggy Lee.
Peggy Lee, Fever.
Fever.
She's terrific too.
Absolutely. So what about classical? Do you have a favorite?
Well, my first opera that I ever saw, I was about 12 years old, and it was Puccini's Tosca. Mm. When the Metropolitan Opera used to tour, and my aunt and uncle, who were very serious amateur opera singers, took me to this opera. And I remember it like it was yesterday. I was so moved and stunned with the beauty of Puccini and the beauty of the production. I couldn't speak for a few hours. That's how overwhelmed I was. And I have been, I've been a true fan of Puccini and Verdi, who are two of the top mm-hmm. Italian composers of mm-hmm. opera ever since. When I was in my 30s, my voice developed into what we call a dramatic mezzo-soprano. And I got hired to sing Wagner roles, and that requires a much stronger, more vivid type of singing, very dramatic singing than some of the Italian operas. And I have done several ring cycles in Arizona, and in fact there's going to be some Wagner concerts in New England this coming summer, which I'll be participating in.
Oh, wonderful. Great. I know you do a lot of voice instruction. You're teaching a lot of up-and-coming singers here in Manchester.
Yes, I love teaching. As you said, we're in my studio, which is on Elm Street in Manchester. Mm-hmm. And I love working with singers of all ages. I have a number of very talented high school singers. I have a couple of singers who are on a commercial track, that is a professional singer track. And I have some lovely adult, what I call avocational singers, who just love to come here and sing and learn new music. And Sometimes I'll do a little studio class here, or we'll rent a space and do performances. I've done abbreviated version of the Magic Flute.
Oh.
And I also am crazy about Bernstein.
Yes.
So I've done a couple of commemorative concerts of his music, especially West Side Story, On the Town, Wonderful Town. He's a fabulous composer.
I believe you're going to be singing a Bernstein piece for us, Take Care of This House, I believe.
Yes, that's from his show, 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue.
Mm-hmm.
It was probably one of his flops, I'm afraid. It just was not a popular show. But the most famous song from it is Take Care of This House, and it's been recorded by artists of all kinds, classical artists, jazz, pop artists.
Julie Andrews, I believe, sang that.
I think she did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Beautiful voice, beautiful song. I hope we're going to get to hear a little bit of a taste of what we're going to be hearing today.
Well, since you asked, I'm just going to sing a tiny bit of Hello, Young Waters, which is, of course, a wonderful love song from Rodgers and Hammerstein's The King and I.
Looking forward to the whole show. There's going to be at least 12 pieces thereabouts.
Oh yeah, at least you probably won't be able to shut me up.
Well, it's going to be great because we're going to have people coming in for the blood drive. We have appointments scheduled from 12 to 5. So, you know, even if you can't give blood for a medical reason, we invite you to come out and sign up for ways that you can get involved. We also have a June 3rd event coming up that's going to be sponsored by WMUR for mm-hmm. a blood drive that we're very excited about as well. So we need all hands on deck, especially at this time where the blood shortage is incredibly low. I wouldn't be here today if it weren't for the Red Cross and the blood donations that...
Really?
Yes. Mm. I've given blood before, and it, you know, it came full circle when I had to receive blood back in 2012. So I'm living testament to the importance of blood and everything that we can do to spread the word, encourage people to get involved. You never know who it may affect. There's accidents that happen every day. We can't be prepared. We don't know what's going to happen. So do what you can to get out there and give blood. If not this coming February 15th event, sign up for the one we have coming up for June. It's an ongoing need. And we thank each and every one of you for being involved. And come out and hear some beautiful music. If you can't donate this time, Janice is going to be there all day on February 15th at Quirk Kia, located at 1300 South Porter Street. And we look forward to seeing you there.